Alright, I liked the lighting. The globe is very metropolitan. I'm trying to think of what the name of the city that it's not the Daily Bugle. It's not Spider-Man's paper. It's the other one that I can't actually remember what it's called. I think it was on in my calendar year last year. I was here protesting the outtakes that my parents set up with Langley Productions and Rima Thaki, if you guys follow. Now, what I heard on the radio at the time sounded very, very, very odd. And they tried to make it perfectly clear they were going to give me a take in LA, and that seems to be correct. What I wanted to basically report I think on what led to protesting on New Year's Eve 2010 was that basically I was told that this is what I found out from the media. I was told that my ex-girlfriend she got the makeover. She was the Black Urban League used Damian Bragg. They somehow made it to Reno, Nevada. And came up with an impersonator, and from there, they confiscated my yearbooks, and also what is considered the angel's harp or nest or the whatever. iPod that has all of the soft copies of LRH, the whole nine yards. If you follow, and I appreciate George Norrie trying to bail me out. I'm not turning down George Norrie at all, but George has to understand that Ryan is Ryan's Jewish. He knows it. It's he's German. His forehead is German, and Mexican, like, is very much like the old man. But he's not unfortunately he is he's not He hasn't been turned off by medications, and he didn't score any of the hits or the escorts that are know of Ryan, or I mean, basically what's happened is the Damian Bragg and the ex-girlfriend and the Smith models are trying to double up. In other words, they're trying to score extra crack and extra VIP passes and sling him to Securitas, Black Urban League, Langley, and so there's no websites, there's no emails, there's no love letter from Angel. It's all hocus pocus. You're just a simple peon nowadays. And to think that ICE is really gonna let any of these people testify to the fact that they rubbed in decades worth of frauds. Basically, we were able to take advantage of the guy, decapacitate him with a Taiwanese spy, and then put his dad on an escort role. I mean, Tom Cruise, how hard is that not to figure out that no one wanted you to score anything? The guy had to go to the freaking service to get a take from Langley Productions. And then that's when the Bushes caved in and they apologized and they're trying to show how it's just another take, reality take or whatever. But I think that what the papers have to understand is that there's nothing wrong with trying to smear the church, but in 2012, I would say that's probably not something that most of the rest of the media wants. These escorts all went to college, scored the synth, screwed my stepmom and sister and ex-girlfriend, and they're still threatening me with AIDS and racket and her harassment, even though they're a bunch of frauds and dirtbag liars, sluts. They don't even have the decency to apologize in writing. I gotta go hire a lawyer. I mean, it just seems pretty lame. A recommendation of the paper would be to let these people like Garcia, like the wetback, the Israeli heifer, the cronies, try and get a affidavit ahead of time, because I'm going to contact my attorney for Social Security, and also I'm going to try and get a new attorney for sexual harassment. Try and get a statement from these guys. See if they want to come out. Spin the reality take that the dorks are actually trying to hold out for 2012. In other words, they're trying to look fresh. They're trying to look as fresh as they possibly can, come up with as much cheddar as they possibly can, and lock the guy away because they don't want to get sued for $50,000 a pop. You see what's going on? Because I don't care about the pussy at all. I've got friends. I can hire a lawyer. We can go gold dig for, you know, what paparazzi, escort, Tom Cruise, whoever is following the guy. You know, I mean, it's just a monopoly diss, or yeah, whatever these guys are saying. You know, and that's the end of the take. Not not a gang, don't look like a gang, don't watch Univision, don't speak, you know, very much Spanish. That's why the heifer decided to suck Damian Bragg off for a decade and leave Ryan in the, you know, in other words, not even be a friend. At least everyone else, the class of 2000, at least they know that, you know, what is fair game and what is outright fraud and perjury and slander and stuff like that. So I really would document, you know, in other words, walk them through, give them a tour of the LA Times, and expose them as a bunch of two-faced, because that's what I'm going to do. That's exactly the smile, the beautiful tit and the red dress and the whole nine yards, a bunch of assholes. A bunch of assholes. And in the very fresh, gentleman-esque take is going to be exactly that. You know what I mean? It's, why all I want to try and figure out is why are you still trying to fraud? I mean, do you really believe that Bush is going to hook you guys up when that type of intelligence, the type of counterterrorism, counterintelligence that it takes to make a terrorist attack like 9/11 is, it takes decades. And that's all these people are doing, is wasting my time, threatening me with the CHP and sexual harassment. Well, ma'am, no one's buying the sexual harassment, because if you even try and sue me, I'll walk away from the U.S. Army or I'll walk away from filing a lawsuit or something. I mean, I don't know why are you being so manipulative that you can't hook someone up with a phone number or shake their hand or send them a letter? It's pretty pathetic and obviously antisocial. Whores, basically, is all we're documenting.